Okay, this is part one of my entry for the Build Lounge Laser Cutter Contest. What I have here is I have a piece of aluminum that I've chucked up into my router. It's going to be a little bit blurry because I put this on macro. It's a home-built router that I built. I'm going to be using this bit, which is a bit that became dull. And so I ground it down to a little tiny point, and I am going to inscribe some Roman numerals onto this piece of aluminum, which will be my clock face. Now, because this is a home-built CNC router, and I didn't totally know what I was doing when I built it, I didn't get the table perfectly square with the travel of the router. And so what I've done is I've taken a block of high-density polyethylene here, and I put a larger bit in and I ran it across this to get this totally square with the travel of the router. And the reason is because I'm only going to push this into the aluminum just I think a hundredth of an inch. And if I'm deeper in one side than the other, it won't look so good. So I'm going to hopefully get good results here. So let's go to it. I'm just about to get going here. I actually did one pass before this shot, but it wasn't quite deep enough. You'll notice that I'm not running the router here. I'm just using it to hold that bit. So let's watch it go. I don't know if you can see anything here. A little bit. And here is the result. I have the Roman numerals engraved into the aluminum. Next step is to cut out the inner circle and the outer circle. I'm just about to start cutting the inner and outer parts, but I wanted to show you this. Here is the standard collet that comes with the router that I chose. It's a quarter inch collet, and most router bits are quarter inch. You can also get some in the half inch variety. I wanted to use a lot of smaller bits, so what I made was my own little collet here. I machined it out of brass, and I can put that in, and now I can use little tiny bits like this. And even smaller, I have a 1/16 inch bit that I use sometimes. Alright, let's get cutting. Alright, I'm all set. I've got it, the bit in the collet. And I'm just going to talk quickly about what I'm going to do here. So I'm going to cut the aluminum, but aluminum isn't necessarily the easiest thing to cut with a router. The aluminum can sometimes gum up on the bit, and so something that I've done that you don't see typically on a CNC router is I've put a coolant system in it. So right here I've got a coolant line coming into a little squirter that I can aim right at the bit. I'm controlling that with a MIDI foot pedal that I've rigged up to a little MOSFET and it's a car windshield wiper squirter that I'm not running it at 12 volts, because if I run that continuously at 12, it'll overheat. So I'm running it at something like 6 or 9 volts. When you're squirting fluid at your cutting bit, you're of course going to need to catch the water, or this is water mixed with a cooling fluid that doesn't allow for rust. You need to catch it. And so what I've done here is I've machined a special catch basin. And I have these channels right here. They're sloped downward. I've got them full of schmutz right now, but they slope downward to some holes that run back to the tank that I keep all the coolant fluid in. So let's get started. So here I have my clock face. You can see how this part is hanging on. Generally when you're cutting a piece on a router, you want to have a little bit of a little tab for something to hang on. I attempted to do that here, but apparently it didn't do it quite right. Most of the time I cut more than one of something, so I thought I got this right, but I guess I didn't. In any case, it worked out well. The reason that you have this little tab there is because, let's say I cut this, and then the air blowing past the router shifted this over, and then I wanted to plunge cut somewhere else. That could be a problem if you hit that, and then this thing starts spinning. It's no good, but we didn't have any problems this time. Fit this real quickly with a file to clean up all the burrs. This is what it's looking like at this point. You can see some surface scratches, but those will come out later. Those won't be apparent. And I have right here a piece of glass that will be behind this. These screw holes will assist to help hold in the glass. The glass will be frosted in the final thing, and I'll show that in a later step.